Good morning, my dear students. We have to continue with the topic, the topo sheet. So, second session of this chapter, interpretation of topographical maps. Very practically, we will discuss about the grid reference. And representation of contours, direction of the rivers and the settlements, measuring distance and calculating distance on the road and the rivers, also drainage pattern. Three drainage pattern we have to identify from the real topo sheet which are providing in exam. Means of transportation in the given area or in the topo sheet. Land use and irrigation. Three types of settlements. Based on the observation of the topo sheet, what occupation it is existing in the area. Here you should remember that this identification of topo sheet is related with the area wherever it is surveyed. India's latitude in between 8 degree north to 37 degree north, it is the main boundary line of latitude. But the 0 degree north to 40 degree north latitude and longitude 60 degree east to 100 degree east, it is surveyed and it is framed the India's survey map or the topo sheet. Specific area it is showing. And also we have learned that 1 million sheet it is using, that is 1:1,000,000, 1 core, that is in the metric system, or in the EPS system it will be 1 inch to 16 mile, this scale which is used in the all over the country where India survey it is taken place. Like that 137 million sheet covering the India's total part, 137 million sheet it is covering. So that you have to remember. Here you have to remember one more thing, that lot of questions can be asked from these sessions. Different questions can be asked based on this topo sheet. So some of the questions, like from the first chapter or any of the, with reference to the survey map number 45D-7 or 45D-10, that consisting the real part of Gujarat and Rajasthan, Gujarat or Rajasthan, it is the real areas. We have to identify the different observations. So the scale it is used in this particular maps which we are getting, we are provided to the exam, that will be representative fraction 1:50,000 only, the scale that is using. And the scale with reference to the ground distance it is giving in your sheet, that is 2 centimeter is equal to 1 kilometer. Each columns one side it represented 2 centimeter, that is equal to 1 kilometer in the ground. So here also one topo sheet it is given. Main features with all the topo sheet, that is heights and contours are given in meter. In contour interval it is 20 meter only. Contours are approximate also. And water features are shown in blue, where they generally contain water. Cultivated areas are also colored in yellow color. And the exterior boundaries of areas of reserved or protected forest are shown by green rib band. Relative height, that is, relative height also showing in the topo sheet, that is giving in the meter. Wooded areas are also colored in green, and also relative height at the same time, relative depth also giving. Relative height at the same time, relative depth also it is giving. Distance stones are also showing in the road in miles or kilometer. Tanks shown in the area usually contain water from different season. Cultivation is periodic and dependent on rainfall, that is also shown with the different seasonal rainfall features like open scrub and meadows and all. So these are the main thing you have to remember. The question related with the define the following, like a ridge, spot heights, relative heights, fire line, causeway, contours, brackish, depression, stony waste, sheet rock, rock outcrop, surveyed tree, embankment, and meander, etc. can ask. So you have to answer this. For example, a ridge. The contour of a ridge are elliptical or elongated in shape. Such a type of contours are called ridge. Spot height. Spot height is the height of a particular point measured and is shown on the survey map. Example also you can write. I can show you in the map how we are finding out the spot height. Triangulated height also there. Benchmark also there. Contours are also there. These four things are showing the height. Now the relative height can ask. For example, 3R will be writing. Then besides a river bank, tank with embankment or sand dune shows the relative height between top and bottom. Hence it should be explained as the relative height of the embankment of the tank is 3 meter. That is also will be shown with the help of the map. Fire line can ask us to define the following question. A cleaning made in the forest to prevent the spread of fire is called a fire line. Clearing made in the forest to prevent spread of fire. Causeway, mostly it is asking, raised or platform across a stream. A stream having a causeway is motorable during dry season. Hence, too many causeways indicate scanty rainfall. Contours also sometimes it can ask. Lines shown in brown color joining the places having the same elevation from the sea level is called a contours. Depression, it is found in the sandy region at the top of a mound or dune where the wind easily blows sand away, leaving a hollow. That means in a desert area it is. Stony weight also it can ask. Sheet rock, surveyed trees with the symbol. Surveyed trees serve as a prominent survey point showing in black color. Embankments can ask. A bank or mound constructed along a tank or artificial lake to prevent the folding. These can be asking in the exam for like the define the following question. You have to write this. So we should familiarize with these signs and symbols. That will be very easy to understand you. Here one of the map it is given. Here you can see one of the longest river it is moving. You can check this. And also many lines are also given here. Different color also it is used here. Written here it's RF scale. So observation how we will make. First we should identify different signs and symbols. For that we will be moving to such type of signs and symbols. First we will start with these symbols, that is the permanent head symbol. It is different types of heads are there. You can see here permanent head is shown here. See, with the red square, shaded red square is showing the permanent head. Temporary head without shading it is shown. So that is temporary head. Deserted town, that is also shown with the help of the red cross here. Settlements, three types are there: nucleated, linear and scattered settlements are here. That is in red color only. Nucleated settlement, it is very closer it is. Then the linear settlement, on the side of a river or a road there will be some settlements are there, then it is called a linear settlement. Scattered settlement means here and there the permanent huts are seen and isolated, then it is called a scattered settlement. All are giving in red color only, that you can see. Again the monuments are shown with the help of red color only. Red it is used here also. Like fort symbol it is given, you can watch here. Then the next one, tower, it is shown there. Antiquities, the old classical monuments are known as the antiquities. That symbol is there. Classical age, medieval period. Mandir or the temple symbol you can see there. Then it is the church, it is given here with the particular symbol. And also mosque it is given here, its symbol you can see. Tomb it is given here. Graves are given with this symbol here. You should identify during your observation, that is why it is taking very slowly. We should understand this later also. See, it is writing some type of, such a type of buildings with the black color. These monuments also giving with the help of red color only, but buildings are giving in the topo sheet by black color only. Post office, PO it is writing, no symbol but writing the PO. Telegram office, old one, conventional only it is. TO it is writing. Telegraph lines are showing like this only, little big and small in between. PTO, post office and telegram office together it is. Police station PS it is writing. DB, dark travelers. So you have to take it seriously. Why? Because we have to write many of the questions answer related with these signs and symbols. Sometimes a settlement wherever it is found, that will be the most important settlement. Why? Question will ask. There you have to observe that the post office is there. DB, you can write DB is there, PS is there, that means this only. So these symbols are circuit house, CH, camping ground CG, and there also dotted square, there you have to write RH, it is forest rest house, it is forest rest house, RH in bracket it will be writing, inspection bungalow, that is also writing there. So these are the monuments and building giving in. Now the roads are giving. So the metal roads and unmetal roads are there. Metal roads are the two parallel lines, not dotted lines. Here it is given unmetal road, that you can see. Pack track, old usage only, pack track. It is a path made by constant use by the men or the animals to travel in the ancient time. That is, even now also it is using as the transportation method. Car track with a single red line, small red line. So whenever we are making the measurement there, you have to identify the roads, then only you can, with the red color it is showing, red it is used here. Footpath with the bridges are also, this symbol it is using. Okay, railway, black color, broad gauge, meter gauge, narrow gauge, three gauges are there, that it is showing with the bright color with these symbols, railways. And also there is level crossing across the railway line, there it is showing with this symbol, red and black it is showed here. Railway line with a station, that is showing here, RS it is writing also there. Okay, some other, that is not that much important. Bridges are also showing here, bridges symbols you have to see here, bridges. Bridge structure constructed across a road, that is shown here. Bridges supporting the pillar. So that much detail will not ask, then also in order to understand I am explaining here. Okay, you can identify this. Now very important one, water bodies, different water bodies. Drainage system we will study. Other than that, here you have to understand the stream, blue color, small blue color it is, stream it is shown here. River, that is larger than a stream, that is shown with the two, three lines in between two black color, one blue line it is used. Okay, important one only is, canals are showing like this only. Again subdivision is there, perennial and non-perennial. River dry, that is in between the black color there will be line, the blue color. River with islands, disappearing stream it is important. Okay, especially in the porous sandy area, some of the desert area, streams which are disappearing before it meeting to the river, main river, this symbol it is showing. That is not the blue color, disappearing stream, very important. Seasonal and non-perennial streams, that is also important. Confluences, where the tributary meeting the main river, that point is known as confluence, you studied. Meander, it's oxbows, you studied in previous class. It is the symbol like this only, you can see there, meander. Sorry. So here you can see waterfalls symbol. Broken ground, that is one of the most important feature. Broken grounds, wherever after the flood it is land without cultivation remains. After the flood, removing, washing away of the fertility, due to that the river areas are uncultivated, unfertility remaining areas are existing, that area is called a broken ground. Okay, then the drainage pattern, three drainage pattern, dendritic pattern. Like the vein of a leaf, it is dendritic, that we will be studying detail in the next session also. Trellised type it is. It is joining the main river at the right angle. Radial type, it is from a core part, it is moving towards the different direction. So that we will be discussing later. Other water bodies, canals connecting to the main river. Tanks, two types of tanks, perennial tanks and non-perennial tanks. You can see and observation, you can make it. So this will not be given in your topo sheet, but you should understand that these are the signs, then only you can write other questions answer. See, dry tanks are given here like this only, with the black color. Relative height also given 4 meters here. But the perennial tanks are given here, main source of irrigation, that is given with the blue color. Color also important. Embankments are also made here. Then perennial wells are important. Perennial lined well, it is important. See here, perennial lined wells. There it is given. In a circle, there is blue color is there. Unlined well, without blue color, it is given here. Always it is asking. It is also known as Kacha well. The relative depth is indicated by number we said it can give most of the time. Brackish, the water which cannot be utilized for drinking, not good for drinking. Well is unfit for drinking. In bracket it will be writing brackish, but there is circle and blue color is there. Two bells are giving like this in triangulated. Springs are giving this symbol. And psalms, that is not that much important. Dams, its symbol is like this only. Where are the barrages is giving like this symbol. Causeway, it is very important. I told you, causeway is a raised platform or a raised area across a minor stream. Whenever there will be the seasonal rainfall is there, then it indicates. And also representation of the height. Spot heights are giving like this. Only example is given. One spot with the number side. Triangulated height, triangle with the different digit number. That is the symbol of spot height and triangulated height. Approximate height it is giving. So with another symbol and small r and number is giving means that is approximate. BM, dot with BM, it is capital letter. Then that is the benchmark. That is the real stone or a building, survey stone or the building, any other surveyed building is keeping as the surveyed area. That is called a benchmark, temporary benchmark. That is giving with the another one. Benchmark of canal, it is simply giving with a dot. Relative height or the depth, it is giving there on the side. Contours are with the brown color. It is important. Contour lines are very close enough, means it is the steep slope. Contour lines are, it is very far away, drawn apart, then it is the gentle slope. So there is the importance of contours, gap. Form lines are giving this symbol. Depression, it is writing middle there, deep itself. So vegetation, vegetative type, different trees are giving, that is also important. A small way it will be giving. open scouts where they were, this symbol is there, there it is important for the cattle rearing. Occupation writing time it is needed. Palm trees or palmera, it is showing with this symbol. Plantation agriculture showing with this symbol. Coniferous trees, cone type of symbol it is giving. Okay, cone type of bamboo trees, you can see here like the grasses. Next one, deciduous trees, see there three same symbols are there. Surveyed tree, sometimes it will be asking from the grid square to find out six figure reference for surveyed tree. If you know this symbol, then only you can take it out correctly. Dense forest or dense jungle, it is writing on the map, don't worry. And also open jungle also writing there, wherever there is green color it is there, it is writing, no symbol but it is writing in this way. Protected forest PF it is writing, remember. Fire line also sometimes it is writing with the dotted lines, brown lines down. And also stony waste are writing there, these are writing on the side, remember. Also sheet rocks are writing there, rock out crops are also writing there. You should know what is rock out crop, what is sheet rock, what is stony waste, then with the symbol you should. Sand dunes it is, you have to know, it is brown color. Not only you have to study with the definition, but also you have to know the symbol, then only you can identify from the map topo sheet, that is important. So these are the main things. So easily you cannot follow this, you should refer this, you should practice this. Some of the symbols you have to draw and study. Commonly which are the symbols it is asking, that you have to observe and study. Otherwise the problem is you cannot find out from the, take out from the observation from the real topo sheet, that is the problem. So here also some of the legends are given, legends all together it is given, that is also you can observe here. See, this is the roads, metal roads, first one it is road, red color, the same thing only but slight difference are there. Okay, all together it was given, you can check it out. Here also wells and lined wells, here the color is not given in your textbook also correctly, but colors are very important. That decides many things. It is called map reading, map analyzing. Keen observation is needed, otherwise your answer can become wrong. See, different things, embankments are shown here, relative height with the tanks are given here. Together two or three symbols can give, that you have to identify and you have to answer it. Symbols rarely only asking directly, but with the help of the symbols you have to observe some questions answer and you have to write, that is important. Most this much things sometimes it is giving on the bottom part of the topo sheet, that is known as legend. See, the trees are given here, palm trees, palmera also it is called a plantation, coniferous, bamboo it is given. Boundary, international boundary with the black color dot lines and dots, sharp one. State, that is marked one, marked and unmarked it is giving. State boundaries and district boundaries, taluk and forest boundaries with the sharpness and the dot, whenever it is decreasing based on that, it is district and tahsil or taluk, village, forest boundaries are marking, with the black color. See here, stations, territories, post office that we already described, Dak Bangla or Travelers Bangla with DB it is writing. So these are the main legends or the important signs and symbols which it is using in your topo sheet. So only the one thing you have to do, you should take your textbook and you have to mark and study, or you have to draw and study, then only you can find out the correct signs and symbols. So I think with this you are very easily you can identify these signs and symbols. Now we are moving to the most important part, that is the area measuring by the grid square method. We have to identify the 6-figure and 4-figure grid reference. Sure question, almost all the question paper, first question is with this finding out of the grid reference only. It is very simple if you are understanding properly. So to find out the area by the grid square method, the grid square on topo sheet measure 2 cm × 2 cm. So that is in the map paper measurement only, scale only 2 cm. Each square it is 2 cm only area, that is 2 × 2 cm only. Or in the real ground it is 1 km × 1 km. That means the scale of the map which is provided, that is the 2 cm is equal to 1 km only. So therefore the area of each square is 1 square kilometer. Sometimes these are written as QC and QD. So remember the scale, this much explained here, that is the scale is equal to 2 cm is equal to 1 km in the ground. 2 cm in the map is equal to 1 km. Other one is given 1 is to 50,000. That is the RF, representative fraction. How the given topo sheet is framed with the help of the scales, different scale, that is only. But in your given topo sheet, so the special topo sheet, the scale is used 2 cm is equal to 1 km, that you have to remember. Now we are moving to the main session, that is the grid reference. How we will identify? First of all, the main thing it is, origin of the map sheet is southwest corner of the map. The reading on the map is always taken with the reference to this origin. So you have to remember that origin of the map always it is southwest corner, this corner, southwest corner. Remember, we are starting from all the things in graph, also in the mathematics, southwest corner only. From here only the x axis and y axis it is moving, x side and y axis it is moving. So here also like that only, we have to start from the observation from the southwest corner, which is shown here, this part only, origin. Then what we have to understand is easting and northing is important. Easting and northing, it is written there. You can remember that easting and northing is shown here. Easting it is here, northing it is shown here. So easting are read to the east of the origin. East of the origin. Origin is here only, southwest corner. Easting are read to the east of the origin, and northing are moving to the north of the origin. Origin is here only, southwest, north of the origin. So from here to here easting, from here to here northing. And we should remember that what are easting and northing. See, the lines which are given vertically from southwest corner to vertically moving towards the east. Vertical lines running towards the eastern side, that lines are called east. Vertical lines, not horizontal. So the horizontal lines running from the origin towards or from the south to north, these lines are, but horizontal lines are known as northings. These crisscross lines together forms the squares. These are called the grid squares. These each squares are having 2 cm length. 2 cm length into width, L into B, that shows the area. Okay, so for identifying the grid square, first we have to take out four figure. Take out the easting in which square it comes. And for getting the northing, that we have to count the horizontal lines. For in order to get the easting, we have to count the vertical lines. In order to count the northing, we have to count the horizontal lines, these lines. So here one example we can see here. Here what is the grid reference of this point P? So we should take out first easting. What is that one? Easting 23, 24, 25, 27, 28, like that it is moving. In the real map also we will practice it. Okay. So here 23, 24, 25th it is. In 25th and 20, here it is given 27. In between 25 and 27, it is actually it is 26 only, it is printing mistake only. 25 and 26, it is given P, it remains. If it is moving 27, it will be crossed. So that within 25 it comes, not after, before. After means it will not take out, within that area we have to take out. So 25 is the easting, that we have to take down and write. Then easting 73, 74, 75, 76. Within 75 and 76 the point remains. So northing we should take out, it is 75. Not the after grid square, before grid square only, inside the grid square only. Most of the students, they are writing sometimes by mistake after that point, but within that point only, inside this grid square only it comes. So the northing is 75, so that the grid's reference of this point P is 25 and 75. Here you no need to write any comma, any point or nothing. Only we have to write 4 digit. 2575 it is called. So the grid square of this point is, point P is 2575. 4 figure only it is. Now, in order to get the 6 figure grid reference, we have to remember 2-3 things. So 4 figure grid reference giving location of the place only. But the 6 figure grid reference, we have to remember here, it gives the pinpoint or the exact position of the object wherever it is correctly we can take out. Pinpoint it is called, pinpoint. So the 4 figure it is given within that area, exactly we not say wherever it is. Pinpoint it is getting through this 6 figure only. In order to get the 6 figure grid reference, some of the steps we have to take out. What are the same thing what we have done for getting the 4 figure, the same we have to do. Then after that, after getting that 4 figure, first easting after we have to leave a little place for writing 1 digit. We have to leave one little space for there. And you have to divide these column into 10 equal parts by using your ruler. By using your scale, you have to divide these specified column, grid square column, you have to divide equally into 10 equal parts. So remember here, why you know that this much area from one side to this side, this much area, it is 1 kilometer only. By dividing equally, horizontally and vertically, 10 equal parts, the real distance will be here 0.1 kilometer. That is equal to 100 meter. By dividing equally, you will get each columns inside this 100 columns you will get. That one column represent 0.1 kilometer actual distance, or it is equal to 0.1 kilometer means 100 meter. So you can use the scale. In the scale, there it is, centimeter scale it is giving. Centimeter scale, one end, zero end there you have to keep. You know there is 1 to 2, 0 to 1 and 1 to 2. There are 20 lines will be there. One line after one you have to leave. Second one you have to mark. Third you have to leave. Fourth you have to mark. Fifth you have to leave. Sixth you have to mark. Like that, one after another one you are marking means you will get here 10 marking points that you have to join. Vertically also, horizontally you have to do that one. I will be showing this how to do in the next map page, then you will understand this. So with that, you will get like this point, columns are marked. So like that, how the easting find out, these columns also you have to count it. After dividing into 10 equal parts, you have to count it in order to get the third figure. 2-5 already there easting. After 2-5, you have to write in which part it comes. You can count it from here, this point P where it comes. 1, 2, 3, 4, fifth part it comes. So 2-5 after 5 you have to write again. Then the northern side also you have to count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, sixth part it comes. So it is a sixth part. After 7-5 you have to write a 6 also. So the 6 figure grid reference for this point P or this temple which is marked, that is 2-5, 5, 7-5, 6. Altogether 6 digits will be there. I think it is clear. See, here is a practical topo sheet we can do. This topo sheet, it is showing the grid reference. Down it is given. There is given the easting from 16 to 25. You can see the easting. Now you know where is the easting. 16 to 25 it is given. 16 to 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 25 it is given easting. Northing it is given 14 to 24. 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, up to 24 it is given. So northing and easting it is given. Now there is 1 is to 50,000 it is given. At the same time, you know 2 centimeter is equal to 1 kilometer. That is the scale which is using here. Okay. Then roads and other things you can see. Here we have to find out a grid reference. You can see in the map. Very curiously you have to see. Observe it correctly. See, I am showing here one of the perineal well, this dot. Once again, you can see there in the here, this side you can see. See one perineal well, it is there. We have to identify its grid square. These perineal wells, grid square we have to identify. This one, perineal wells. In order to get that, we should first of all divide these into 10 equal parts with the help of your scale. 10 equal parts. Horizontally and vertically you have to make it. Very carefully you have to do it, then only it will get. Then you have to take down the easting and northing. Here you can see easting it is. Count it from there, then only it will be easy. Here I told it is 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, not 21. 21 means it will come here. 20 only. So easting 20, take it and write there 20. Then give a small gap for writing one digit. Here also we have to find out. Then after that we have to take out its northing. Northing it is, what it is given? 14, 15, 16, 17, 18 and 19. Within 18 and 19, that is why not crossing after 18 you have to take out. 19 means it will come this column. So 18th one only. 18th one. So now we got easting and northing. 20 and 18. 20 and 18. Then hereafter we have to see in which part this perineal well it exists. There you have to count it, the columns, 1, 2, second one it is. So, 20 after you have to write 2, second part only, 1, 2, this side, vertical lines, that is easting also, here we are counting first. Then, we should count the northing, this side, which part, 1, 2, 3, 4. So 18 after we have to write 4 also. Second part and fourth part it remains this perineal area, perineal well area. Perineal wells sign only it is. So the grid square you are getting, that is 22, 202, 184 is the grid square of this particular perineal well. This way there can be lot of question can ask. This is the most important one. This way it can be asking very important many questions like this. Grid square question can ask. I think it is clear to you. So this is the way we have to find out the grid square. Again, there are another map is given here. From there we can take out some observations. So in this given map, there is give the four grid reference of Dadaldra, one of the place. Four grid reference settlement it is Dadaldra. So how we will find out Dadaldra, that settlement you have to find out it first of all, where it is. So this one is here only, very very keenly if you are finding out, then only you can get it. See, it is here only. Then you have to count its easting. From the southwest corner you have to count it. So it is given here 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, it comes here only 10 it is. So the easting is 10 or 10. here it comes. Not crossing that one, here it is. Then north you have to count 18, 19, 20. So 20, not 21. Within 20 it comes. So this place called Dadaldra is within the grid reference of 1020 or 1020 it comes. This area it comes. Second also it is given, there you can find out the Bamra. Bamra, where it is Bamra. You should find out first of all that Bamra. I think this side it is Bamra. See here, this one is Bamra. You have to find out the easting. That is again you have to count 2, 3, 4. Bamra here only, within 4 it comes, not crossing that one. Here only most of the part it comes, that is why it comes in 4, easting of 4. Then count it to the northing also, that is 18, 19, 20, 21. Little part is there, but major part it is 20 only. That is why we can take out that 20. So this Bamra, that settlement, that town or a small village, it's that settlement, it is remaining in the grid square of 0420. I think it is clear. So like that questions can ask. And sometimes from this it will be asking, where is the settlement or which is the largest settlement shown on the map extract? Which one communication facility is exclusively available to this settlement? Which is the largest settlement it is asking? You have to find out. So largest settlement is asking means you have to find out the most important features, like man-made features. So you have to see the post office, telegram office, dispensary, railways, causeways, etc. Many things it is going. First of all, you can see that the large settlement showing with the red color, that one. Here you can very clear, Dantrai is the largest settlement. See here. Because there is PO it is written, post office is there. Reason also sometimes it will be asking. So PO is written, post office it is written, and also sometimes the railway lines can be there. It is connected with the different roads also. Settlements are very close to each other. So that make it is the largest settlement. So that is the answer you have to write here. Now one another observation, that is very, very keenly you have to observe then only. Like that questions it will be asking, that is why we are doing here also. Give the 6-figure grid reference of spot height 339 or the largest spot height. Sometimes it will ask. Here it is asked 339. Spot height with the spot and the number it is giving. We have to observe very carefully and we have to find out 339 spot height. See, observing here means I find out here spot height. While finding the spot height, you have to check the contours also. There it is the height increasing. So I find out here 339. This is the largest or the 339 spot height. And the smallest also asked here, smallest it is asked in the same, smallest one observation you have to make. If you are doing many topo sheet work, then only it can easily you can do. You have to remember that 2 hours only for the exam, total exam. So 274 I find out here. So both you have to find out the 6-figure. First of all, in which square it comes, easting, northing you have to find out here also. Then you have to divide it with the 6 columns. Then you can identify it's a 6-figure. That is a good task if you are doing whenever you are getting experienced, then only you can take out this. This is the practical method I am showing that you have to do with your topo sheet, which is given at the end of this chapter. Different topo sheet works are given with the answers. Please, you have to revise and do it. Then it will be easy for you. Otherwise, it will be difficult for you. So I think it is clear. I have taken much time to explain this. I know very slowly only I have taken. Because of that only grid reference, it is little bit difficult for you. So that the 3-4 examples also I have done, the practical examples here. So remember that 6-figure grid reference, how it is identifying with the different features. Okay, practice it. And signs and symbols also you have to practice. You have lot of work this week. Before Wednesday, you have to complete these things. Then only the further study we can make it. You can see in screen, grid reference only we have completed. And representing the relief by contours, that is also important. Direction, that is very important. Direction and measuring distance, calculating by the direct method and by using the thread or paper string, that is also we have to do. Drainage pattern also. So some this side it is easy only. You can score the mark. Okay. Most important thing, grid reference and the measurement and the direction, which river, which side it is flowing the river, or the settlement is in which side or which direction, that we have to find out. Drainage it is finding out. These are the little difficult part. So if you want to do this, all the practical things what is shown in your screen, you have to understand, or you should familiarize with the symbols and signs which we have studied beginning of this session. So do practice the signs and symbols. Some of the symbols you have to draw and study. Observation you make means sometimes you confuse with that. Same type of signs and symbols are there. Not only that, some of the grid reference with the 4-figure and 6-figure you have to do and see. Sometimes you may think that it is easy to do, but by doing and practicing, then only you can do it in a good way without any mistake in your exam. If you are mistaken, it is taking place in with the 1 digit, your answer will be wrong, your mark will be losing. That is why do it sincerely. So we are ending today's session. Thank you.